My name is Kathy Small Rice. I'm from Minneapolis, Minnesota. Prince was my first kiss. Of course, nobody knew who he was, just had a big afro. My first job out of college was with the airlines. I realized that I love to be around people that travel because I love to travel. When I met my second husband, I said that I wanted to get married in Malta, and he was down for that, and he was excited about that as well. So we went to Malta and got married. When we came back from that trip, I got sick and had to go for a hysterectomy. After the procedure, the blood transfusion didn't work, and the hematologist did many tests on me. He decided to do a bone marrow biopsy, and through the bone marrow biopsy, they found the myeloma. It became clear to me that that was something very serious and that it is treatable, but it's not curable. I never understood what relapse meant until my first relapse from the stem cell transplant. After that, it was relapse, relapse, relapse. That was the buzzword. I stopped counting at 10. That's when I was introduced to clinical trials. I got a doctor at the Mayo Clinic in Rochester, Minnesota, and that was how my first clinical trial began. I felt like I was part of science. I didn't tell my family right away about the clinical trial. I felt that I needed to sit on it for a minute to understand what it was so I can explain to them. And explaining to my mother was very hard, but my husband and family and my kids, they were real supportive. And they said, whatever you decide, but it was hard. The social worker came and they basically did all of the legwork for me. They found the place that I wanted to live, the dates and times, everything was all set up. So all I had to do was show up. My suggestion to anybody who's doing a clinical trial would be to make sure that they have somebody to guide them, somebody to help. And the social worker helped tremendously with that. After the clinical trial was over, like you had to wait a month. And when I went to the doctor, he told me it didn't work. I was okay with that. Knowing what I knew about clinical trials, I knew that I could go ahead and the next one could work. They're coming up with a lot of drugs, and the only way that these drugs get to market is through clinical trials. My second one was CAR-T. CAR-T was the one that everybody got the big R from, and I wanted the big R. And I didn't get the big R, but fatigue is, for me, was a big issue with all the treatment. And I would tell my doctor, I'm just tired all the time. He's like, well, go to sleep. Simple as that. But then when you sleep, you miss out on a lot of things and you miss out on doing and traveling. And that was probably one of the hardest parts for me, is having to just be still. I just had to sit and relax and enjoy my home surroundings. And I was told a feeling throughout this journey that I needed to just sit and just be. And I would say to most people, keep it simple. Listen to your body. If your body tells you to sit down, sit down. I've learned not to worry about everything because it'll still be there. You can eventually do it if you listen to your body. I'm just keeping life simple, doing the things that I love, being with the people that I love, enjoying the things that I love to do. I'm here. I'm alive. It's wonderful being alive.